And welcome to the market wrap for Friday, the 27th of October. Well, the Aussie market did lift today to end the week. We lifted by about a fifth of 1%, which means we did narrow our losses over the week, but we still fell by about 1%. And it also means the Aussie share market managed to buck the trend, given that Wall Street actually fell overnight on the back of mixed earnings results and hotter economic data. In terms of sector performance, we saw about half the sectors managing to improve. Consumer staples were the outperformers, boosted by supermarket giants Coles and Woolies. The major banks were higher, which helped lift financials, but falls in insurance stocks offset bigger gains. Miners were higher too, but tech stocks did worse following those falls on the NASDAQ overnight, while industrials and communication services were some of the worst as well. In terms of the winners today, Champion Iron was the second best after a couple of analyst target price lifts. Core Lithium rose after reporting a lift in spodumene production over the quarter and said it's on track to achieve its full year guidance, while shares of Harvey Norman lifted despite reporting a hit to both its revenue and profits over the quarter, with its net profit halved compared with the same time last year. The company did announce, though, that it will buy back up to 10% of its shares, valued at around $442 million, and this could be why we did see its shares lifting today. Looking at some of the losers, general insurer Steadfast was among the worst after hosting its annual general meeting. Health tech company ResMed was under quite a bit of pressure after reporting that its margins were being squeezed by higher costs. And shares in pallet maker Brambles fell most today. It received a number of target price cuts following its quarterly results on Thursday. Over to currencies, the Aussie dollar has recovered a little since that CPI print on Wednesday, currently buying 63.4 US cents. Then looking ahead to tonight, we will get that all important PCE deflator out of the US. That's the Federal Reserve's most closely watched measure of inflation. And then some of the highlights next week on Monday here in Australia, we'll get consumer spending figures. That'll really be the last piece of the puzzle before the next interest rate decision. Then over in the US, they'll hand down their interest rate decision, where most likely they'll keep rates on hold. And we'll also get jobs data out of the US at the tail end of the week on Friday. Have a lovely weekend, everyone, and we'll do this again on Monday.